Welcome and greetings and salutations. Hi, I'm Frank, and today I'm going to go on here a very, very important factor. One of the things I'm going to work on today is through this long list I have of things to do here. Okay, and I still have an old school. I still use this thing here. It's called a pen. But I want to go through and explain to you about exporting your entire project here as a report. This is important. This is what your boss wants to see. This is what you're going to show your investors. This is what is going to say, we're working on a project. I'm looking for this. I'm looking for that. Or somebody says, hey man, can you send me what you're looking at? I want to see it. Because you're all happy. You're working on a project. Now, all of a sudden, wow, I have a project. How do I send it out? How can everybody see what I'm doing? All right. In some of our previous images, what we went through is we went through different soil types. We went through the different colorizations. We went through the scan information and characteristics. But I'm going to go and do that again here really quickly so that you can take a look at it. I'm going to flip you over here to the camera here. So we're going to move this camera over to this magic screen. Okay, and in this screen, what I want to show you very simply here is we're going to take an example again of what we have. I'm going to come onto the screen. I'm going to push the F9 key, which is also the characteristics. The reason I want to do this is that we get all of the details in our scan so that when we write this report, and this little report here, this is PDF report, and this is in the professional edition. So if you don't have the professional edition of the software, I highly recommend it. If you're going to have to sell your scans off, you're going to show people your information, you want to format a very professional analysis of what you're doing. And when you do this, it is already pre-formatted. It makes it so much easier. I am one of those who turn around and get lazy, okay? Be honest with you. I want to just be able to go click, 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 and then I have it done. Well, there's a little bit more work to that, but we're going to start off here. We're going through our characteristics. And in this characteristic field here, I'm going to simply just start off with my characteristics. General notes, what was I doing? Where was I? So as I'm going to turn in here, we were here for a wonderful company in West Virginia here. And it's called Allegheny Mining. I have to give you a little shout out there. Thank you very much, guys. I had a great time. Wonderful hospitality. And they're in the process of searching for abandoned gas wells. So in this process, we did a whole bunch of scans in West Virginia. Absolute beautiful, beautiful part of the world. And very impressed, nice people, everything beautiful. We cannot complain. We were out there, we ran the equipment, we showed them how to work it, and we're quite satisfied with that. In other things that we've done, we've seen other instances, and I'm using an example from them. So I'm coming down here, down the line, enough of the blibber blabber, and I'm going to come in here in my notes section here on the characteristics. That's pushing the F9 key, and then I come into the characteristics. The very first thing here is the general area here, general, okay? And now I'm saying, what was I doing here? Okay, we did a scan. My typing is not the best, so maybe we can fix that with the magic of video editing. Scan over the I'm going to write in here first quadrant to the south. Okay, now this is so I know where I was. Whatever you do, realize where you were. Take your image and realize where you are. If you have to put a wooden stake in the ground and a flag on the stake here, mark it. This is my position. This is where I did the scan. You have a GPS. Get your, excuse me, I gotta go here. Everybody has a handy dandy here telephone. Okay, it's got a GPS in it most of the time. If you're within an area where you get cell service, use this, know where you are. Because if you find something and you don't know where you are and you show everybody, look what I found. And they say, great, hey, I want to go with you, show it to me. And then you stand there and you go, oh man, I don't know where I was. Wow. That will mess up your whole day. If you want a bad day, build up something exciting and lose half of it. Believe me, I've done it. Take your location, know where you are. You have a telephone, it has a GPS. But some of these telephones are even modern, they have cameras. Use it, take a picture. However you do it, there's no best way. Just remember to write your location down. You're on the road, you're 30 seconds from this turn at this speed, so you know where you are. That would be called a dead reckoning. You have meets and bounds, you have GPS. There are many different factors how you can locate yourself so you can find your position again. It is important. So, all right, I write in here, what it says, scan over the first quadrant to the south. I know where I am. I have my location. I know where it is, okay? We had a stake with flag number, and I will say one for argument's sake. So now there's a stake in the ground, wooden stake in the ground. There's a little flag on it, and it's got a number. Now I know exactly where I was. That's one way to do it. Know where you are. Okay, then we're going to go through here. What was the time of day? We have a good thing because in the software, it's going to tell you the time of day. So you'll be able to see right up here in the project title, it's going to say, for this one here, I used the Rover C4. Nice instrument, handy dandy. Okay, and with that Rover C4, I used the super sensor. It was there. So I want to know I used the super sensor. These are important things. You're going to make your report, make it right. This way you know how to go and reproduce it. Or you'd be lazy and say, so sorry, I don't know where I was. I just found here, what do I know? A lost Flying Dutchman gold mine, and I lost the location. Sorry, I guess I have to be rich another lifetime. No. It doesn't work, but make sure they have that. Okay, so we're with the super sensor. So we're giving all of our details in here. Sensor. All right, then let's go down the line. We want to know our scan field. Do we have a scan field? Do we have an overlay? There are some people who are getting really, really slick and they're getting really high tech and they bring their kids with. And their kids have drones and they have other things like that. So let the drone go flying up high and they'll take a picture from the top down. You can lay this picture right into here if you have it. And you can do that. Works out well. Another way to say, this is my location. So if you happen to be really slick, or you happen to be like me and you have kids who are really slick, tell them to shoot a drone up and take a picture of it. It gives them something to do, and they're happy that they have something to do here. Now let's go on down the line. We have soil types. Soil types are important. Sometimes. I have a video here, I think here, on soil types. You need to really watch it. Soil types are important. When you know the kind of soil you have, then you can better determine the depth. If you don't know the soil type that you have, then you can't expect to know the depth. As you look at the different soil types, you have your top layer, your topsoil, and then it will keep on going down through your different layers until you end up at bedrock. If you don't know what's in between, we are on this wonderful planet Earth, and this planet has millions and billions of different combinations. Every area can be different. To best know your soil type is to do a test on a known object in the area that you are searching in so that you can better guesstimate. If you don't know what you're doing, as I click here, I go to neutral because I don't know the depth. Am I going to trust what it is? I don't know. Am I in rocks? Am I in clay? Am I in swampland? I don't know. I can't tell you what's underneath if I'm walking on top. If I have 2 meters or 3 meters of solid soil and then I have a large area of water underneath, I can't see it from up there. So you have to work with what you have. If you don't know your soil type, you can pick out neutral. It works out, it's neutral. Okay, it fills in a thing, a void. Then we have here on the next section is the metadata. This is important. All of the little miscellaneous things that you want to include, this is where you have to have it. It is somewhat important. Wait a minute, I'm going to jump a little bit. I just thought of something. Just to liven it up a little bit. Let's go back to general. As I went back to general here, I have the field length and the field width. That was important. It's already pre-filled here because I did it from the very beginning, but I forgot to mention it. So just so that I have put a little twist on this video, you can click back up here to the general. And now we're going to go back down to the last option here, metadata. Okay? And this is all of the information that we want to have that may be pertinent to us. What is pertinent? Pertinent could be the weather. It was clear, it was sunny. So I can click up here on this little cross, this little plus sign here, and I give it a name. And then over here, I'm going to type in weather. Okay, the weather, okay, we were sunny. Okay, and cool. There we go, and I hit okay. So now it made an entry into this weather. If I look outside, the weather here is getting to look like above the clouds is sunny. Yes, I can see there is a hole there, and above there it is sunny. Put it down there. Was it wet? Was it dry? These are all factors that help you do this. If it is raining, I don't recommend to do the scans when it's raining. I have these things here, they're called electronics, and sometimes the electronics don't like to take a bath. So you don't need to throw them into the bathtub. Okay, leave them dry. If it rains, darn, bad thing. You have to live with it, but we'll put that over there. Okay, so weather is important. Were there any other underlying conditions? Was there debris? Was there garbage, rubbish, trash? However it is said in your part of the world. Were the things that you had to watch out for? Did you have metal debris that was just hanging around there from old nails to tins to cables to whatever you have out there? Look at the ground, see what you have. If you were debris free, we could say here, okay, surface was clear, okay? Surface debris. These are things that people want to know what's in there, because if you're going to send me the report, I'm going to look at this report and I don't know any of these things. These might be some of the questions that I have, okay? And this could be here, free from metal fragments. Let's spell this correctly. Metal fragments. Okay, there we go. And I can hit okay. And these are all the little details that you can put up there. What did you run into? Were there rocks there? Were there something that was significant? Is it a natural area? Is it a backfilled area? If it's backfilled, do you know any of the details? The more details you put in your report, the more complete it is, the less questions come out afterwards. So once we're done, I'm going to hit OK. Now that I've hit OK, I'm going to look at my scan. Looking at the scan now, we're going to go right to the very top. This image that you're going to show them on the report is the same image you're looking at in the screen. So if you have a side view, if you have a top view, if you have a different view, this is the view that they are going to see. So if you have a side view and you have all the long elongations here of everything, this is what they're going to see. If you have the top view, this is what they're going to see. So you take a look at which view that you want to show them in the report, because this very first view is what they're going to see. Okay, it is important. And this is all these little things that everybody wants to look at. You can also come up into your windows here, okay? And you can cascade your windows if you have multiple here that you want to show off. One moment here. Arrange side by side if you have multiples. And these are all these little factors that are going to be seen. These are things that people want to definitely see, okay? You can come to your default view, and now you have one picture where you have everything in one shot. I got my top view, I have my side view, I have my oblique view or skewed view or angled view, however you want to put it. These are what they're going to see. Then, going on to PDF report, push on PDF report. It's going to give you this little screen. Export as PDF. This is important. Where am I going to save it? So now that you know where it's going to go here, Documents Visualizer 3D Studio. So when you have your location and you know exactly where you're going to store it, these are important. So you're going to go in there and you're going to say, okay, this is where I want to hit. So I'm going to hit here, save. All right, so now that you've got your location saved, you're going to hit export. It's going to export this file and it's going to build it all up so that you'll have a full and complete visualization of what you're looking at. Alrighty, the very first picture here is what was on our screen. As you see here, that was on our screen, and this is right here. So this is the picture that's going to come up right off the bat. This is what everybody's going to see. Now, we're going to scroll down a little bit, and it says this is the day, the date, the time. Here's all that important information that you put in there at the very beginning. Remember I said in the general field, this is what we're going to put in. And it's a Rover C4 that's in there. We have, this was created here on this day. This is when we did the scan. Of course, it says here it was done at 22:05. We have to do that minus the time difference because, see, we got this thing, I mean, like Germany, and they're like in America. So we have this time difference because this planet is round. So if we take off the time off of that, you say, okay, we did a nice afternoon shot. It was 4 o'clock in the afternoon. That's how that works. We're going to go down 5 meters by 5 meters. We did 20 impulses, 12 scan lines. This is all in here. I made down here in my notes here. Okay, scan over the first quadrant to the south. Okay, stake, oh, with flag number one. My writing is horrible and I can prove it. Look at the mistakes I made, but I still understand what I wrote. So I will take my pen here. Well, maybe I should not write on the laptop. Somebody might be angry with me. I'll just maybe find some here, white out or liquid here, fix. And no, I better not do that either. I'll move the screen. So here we have the metadata and exactly what we went through that metadata. What was there? We're going through here to show them what our extra stuff was. What was our scan mode? We did impulse mode. Was it automatic? First of all, when I can do automatic, I know that the ground is relatively flat. It means I can traverse it fairly quickly. Then I have my soil type. Remember, we went through the different soil types. These are important factors that everybody wants to see. So in one shot, here is a PDF. It's a couple pages. Shoot it out per email to the next person, and you can show them, here's everything that we have, and this is how it works. All right, we're going to move on to our next subject here, the next video, and I'm going to close off this one for right now. I thank you very kindly, and look forward to you looking at me again. Thank you.